Hi, this is Sean, and in this video I'm going to give an introduction to Kismet and triggers. We are going to talk about what's an event, how to trigger an actor. Specifically in this case, we're going to just be basic and turn a light on and off and trigger a comment, which will be useful for debugging in the future. Alright, let's get started. So here's a quick maze that I built, and my goal is going to be making a light turn on and off when I step on or near a certain area. So there's an actor that makes doing certain actions or triggering things very easy, and that actor is called a trigger. So you right click and you say add actor, and this is always available. So I'm going to say add trigger, and this is what it looks like. So now that we have a trigger created, we will make a light that will turn on and off. So in the past I mentioned that if you hold down the L key and you click, you can create a light. Now in UDK, I'm going to delete that, and I'm going to show you that there's other light actors. So if I pull up the content browser, which is already open, and right here in the actor classes under lights, the standard point lights, they can't talk to Kismet. So the movable and toggleable lights are much more easy to connect to the Kismet area. And what is Kismet? Kismet is a node-based programming system that allows you to string together pieces of code which will create basic interactivity inside of your level. So in this case, we're going to add a point light toggleable, because we want to be able to turn the light on and off. And I'm going to put it right here. So I have it selected in the actor classes, and I'm going to right click and add point light toggleable here. And so we can differentiate this light a little bit. I'm going to hit F4 and go into the object properties. I'm going to make the brightness higher. I'm going to make the radius lower, and I'm going to make the color a bit red. And let's see, we can even turn on some like light shafts that will make it a little bit more interesting. So this is what we've got going here with all our light. It'll be much more easy to see. All right, and so now what we need to do is we need to hook up this trigger so that when we step on it, it will turn this light on. So in fact, this light is on right now by default. So what we need to do is actually turn it off to start. For almost all objects that you want to toggle on and off, what you want to look for is the enabled function. So right now, you can see that if I toggle this on and off, I can make it enabled or not enabled. So I'm going to make it turned off to start. And then I'm going to go into Kismet with this trigger selected. And this K up at the top, it will open the Kismet. So when I right-click in Kismet, I can say I want to create an event to happen when I've touched this trigger. And there's new event using the trigger, and here are my options. Well, I could say if I shot at it, maybe it could take damage, that could trigger an event, or a certain aimed or used or touched. So touched is what I want. And this is the trigger. And you can see that it indicated a chunk of options that will open up when that's selected. When it's deselected, nothing there. When it's selected, probably one of the two most important ones in here are the max trigger count and the object comment. The max trigger count is how many times can this event be activated. You can see the pop-up as I roll over this. So in fact, I want this to be toggleable in a sort of infinite way. And so by putting a zero here, that will allow me to touch this and turn the light on, touch this and turn it off, touch this and turn it on, eventually, once I hook it up to the rest of the sequence that I create. So then as I touch the trigger, I want to set off a comment. And this will be this is useful for making sure your triggers are working in the right way. So I'm going to say trigger touch, and you can see that it puts the comment above the Kismet object. And then I also want, when I'm testing this level out, to output this to the screen. So that's where this checkbox will take effect. And so now what I want to do is, since this is a toggleable light and I've created an event, I want to, so when this object is touched, turn the light on. So that would be an action. So we have an event, and now we need an action, and we need a toggle. So here's all sorts of actions that we can take. And here's the toggle. So I'm going to say, when I touch the trigger, I'll turn the light on. Maybe when I don't touch the trigger, I'll turn the light off. So how do we make sure that the target is the light bulb? And so I will select the object in the scene. And if I right click, I can create a new object variable using the point light toggleable. There it is. The icon shows up. If I hold down the control and left click, I can move it around. What's even easier as a workflow option is if you select the object and right click over the what you want to connect it to. So now I've actually connected this. If I hadn't, I can break that connection. I could sort of simply click and attach this to the variable here. So that's pretty much it. Let's give it a try. I'm going to play my level from here. I touch the trigger, and you can see the trigger touched shows up. And when I step off the trigger, the light turns off. So that's it for basic interactivity. I'm going to stop the video, and we'll continue this interactivity series with an introduction to interp actors in the next video. Thanks for watching.